This is about defending democracy.
This is no longer Democrats versus Republicans.
What do you want your kids to believe in? There must be give and take.
This is White Flag with Joe Walsh.
He just kept going on and on about how they're ruining America. My God, Joe, he kept saying, how can you vote for them? How can you vote for them? All these different genders. You got 60 some different genders. Open borders. They want bad people into this country. Joe, don't you get this? How in God's name can you support them? They can't stand this country, Joe. My God, what are you thinking? I got an absolutely over-the-top, angry, irate phone call last week from a former supporter of mine, still a strong, hardcore MAGA Trump guy, just going on and on. He couldn't believe that I was going to support Biden again. They want to ruin this country. They're socialists. They're communists. They're letting everybody into this country. There's crime everywhere. They're changing the values of this country. They don't want this to be a Christian country anymore. We can't say Merry Christmas. I mean, it went on for a good 4 to 5 minutes. This former Joe Walsh supporter, this huge Trump supporter, completely mystified as to how I could again be supporting Joe Biden over Donald Trump, and just screaming at me about all that they're doing to ruin the country. He was angry. He was scared. He was really pissed off. And this went on for about 3 or 4 minutes. And by the way, if you're wondering, yes, he did have my cell phone. Because if you're wondering, when I was a member of Congress and when I was a right-wing radio TV guy, I gave my cell phone out to way too many people. And he had it, and he got into my ear last week and just gave me an earful. Don't you fucking understand, Joe? They're purposely ruining everything we hold sacred. And after 3 to 4 minutes of this, and he finally paused. He stopped. I just said, I'm sorry. I said, Steve, I want to apologize. I want to apologize directly to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I pissed you off. I'm sorry that I got you so wound up about the left. I'm sorry, I said, that all those years on the radio and on TV, when I yelled about crime coming across our border, and I yelled about 64 different genders, I'm sorry that I got you so damn worked up. I'm sorry that I did that to you, that you're now at the point where you're convinced that Joe Biden and the Democrats are purposely trying to ruin this country and purposely trying to get rid of everything you hold dear. All I could think of was to apologize to him for the role that I played as a right-wing flamethrower, a right-wing bomb thrower back in the day, who went on the radio every day, went on the TV every day, and purposely tried to anger my audience, scare my audience. What they all still do today, Hannity, Levin, and all the rest of them. What Rush Limbaugh made a fortune doing. Scaring the shit out of our audience, because that's where the ratings were. All I could think of last week was to apologize to him. Here's a guy who I know, who's convinced that the Democrats are purposely trying to ruin this country. And what went through my head is, how the hell did he get here? And then what went through my head is, I helped get him here. And all I could think was to apologize. I stopped him in his tracks on that phone call. And I said, I'm sorry. And I explained. I said, I'm sorry for the role that I played to feed you such bullshit, to purposely get you wound up and outraged so that you'd listen to me. I wasn't alone, I said to him. Everybody in the right-wing media world did it. And now you've got right-wing members of Congress who do it, and they're still doing it. And I stopped doing it a long, long time ago, but I said, I'm sorry, Steve. You're wrong. Biden and the Democrats aren't trying to ruin America. They're not trying to purposely destroy everything you believe in. Not even close. And I'm really sorry that I helped get you here to where you believe this. He didn't get it. By the end of the phone call, and it was about a 10-minute phone call, what are you doing, Joe? What are you doing, Joe? How can you support them, Joe? He didn't get it. And I hung up. We hung up. And I was just profoundly sad. Every week, every day, every week, I engage with Trump supporters. Most are unreachable. Not all. He was unreachable. And I helped get him there. So if you're wondering why the past few years I'm doing everything I can to amend for what I did, to fix what I helped produce, this is why. We've got to get people like that out of that place. Thanks for listening. I'm Joe Walsh. This is White Flag with Joe Walsh. JoeWalshWhiteFlag@gmail.com. All one word, JoeWalshWhiteFlag@gmail.com. Be brave.
Thank you for listening. Remember to listen, share, and follow White Flag with Joe Walsh on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and everywhere great podcasts are found. And be sure to leave a 5-star review. This has been White Flag with Joe Walsh.